The Toronto Maple Leafs were literally one win away from going to the Stanley Cup final, potentially against the Montreal Canadiens. So think about that for a moment. Toronto, Montreal, Stanley Cup final.
Good evening again, everybody. We're at the Great Western Forum for Game 6. Referee tonight is Terry Fraser.
Rudy played it up on the boards. Here's Anderson intercepted in front of the net, took the pass, and now Gilmore. Anderson scores! Anderson got a break, really. He didn't get much on it. It came off the heel of his stick, but it got by Rudy. Leafs do not get it out. Sidor shoots. That's blocked. Sidor again, keeping it in. Here's Sidor. He goes back to the net. Tries to come out front with the pass. Mad scrambled to the left to Ponta. They score. The puck is in the net. Donnelly on the boards, and the Leafs get it out. It's chopped to center to Foligno. Here's a break for Clark. Clark coming in. He scores. Wendell Clark with a high shot on a clear break. And the Leafs take the lead 2-1.
Well, Wendell Clark gets a backhand up over Kelly Rudy and showed some speed of foot to stay ahead of the King that's chasing him. And here's the long pass. It's tipped by Krushelnicki, and it goes by Huddy, and then he changes and just puts it up as Rudy goes down a little too early. Wendell shields the puck nicely there with his left leg and then puts it up like he's a goal scorer. A great goal by Wendell Clark.
Robitaille got rid of it. Sandstrom. Out front, sure! McSorley ties the game. The Kings looking to take the lead. Robitaille missed it. Sidor shuts, scores! To the blue line, who took a shot. Score! Lead pass with a good one to Clark. Clark going in and Rudy scores! Clark against McSorley, and he had Rudy up on the wrong foot and blasted a low shot, and the Leafs are backhanded on that goal by Wendell Clark.
Well, that's his first of this series. You remember earlier in the third period, he tried the same play and missed the net and looked like he had Rudy beaten. A lovely pass by Bob Rouse. Clark gets the puck to the inside on Marty McSorley and then wrists it.
Keep the puck in, 1:25 remaining. It is center, Clark scores! Wendell Clark, third goal of the game, and ties it here with 1:21 remaining in regulation time.
And the goaltender was out, Bob, and I'm pretty sure it was Wendell Clark who came off the bench to replace Potvin. And it was a lovely little drop pass coming up right here. Wendell coming off the bench and getting the puck as he poured through the slot from Doug Gilmore. And he made no mistake as he ripped that wrist shot for his third goal of the night.
The assist to number 93, Doug Gilmore.
What great action.
So with 12 seconds to go, Glenn Anderson takes a penalty for checking from behind.
Gretzky moving toward the net now. The shot, that's blocked. And it hurt Gilmore. He stopped the shot. It hurt him. He fell. And the play was called.
It was Wayne Gretzky's stick, Bob, I believe. And Carey Fraser's going to the linesman and can call high sticking penalty. Let's have a look now. Gilmore's cut. Now the top of the screen, here's the shot. McCowan blocks it. It comes back out. Gilmore gets it, and there's where Gretzky's stick came up and hit Gilmore. They're not going to give him a penalty by the look of it. It certainly was accidental. But tell that to Gilmore. He's got to get his chin stitched up.
I thought it was McCown who stood in front of the shot by Gretzky. Gilmore was very close, but as we saw on the replay, the shot blocked, and then Gretzky's stick came up and clipped Gilmore. On the line, trying to go in, and Zezel takes the puck away from Robitaille. Robitaille gets it back center. They score! Gretzky scores!
People who are Leaf supporters think this is a conspiracy to get the LA Kings into the final.
Hey!
You agree with that? Well, that's ridiculous to agree with that.
I didn't agree with nothing. I just said, hey, you said it, not me.
No. Well, so you disagree or you agree with the fans that feel that way?
Hey, you're telling the story, kid.
Oh, I said a lot of people feel that way who are supporting
you
the
don't?
Leafs, understandably. No,
Yo.
Of course not.
Oh.
The other question is about the other night in overtime.
Yes.
The Wayne Gretzky high stake. I'm sure the fan would like to hear your point on that.
I've been home now for 24 hours. I must have been asked 9,000 times about that incident. Figure it out. Here's a guy who gets eight stitches in his chin. The referee calls the guy over. He says, "Did you see what happened?" "No, it's not my side. Did you see what happened?" "Well, wait a minute. If I tell you, that means 5-minute major. If the linesman says 5-minute major..."
No, it could be a 4-minute penalty.
Yeah, he's got, anyhow, going into overtime, Gretzky, verge of elimination. So what do we do? What do they say? How about he gets hit with a puck? Gets hit with a puck. He's laying on the... Before he hits the thing, the only way he hit with a puck is if his chin was on the ice. Anyhow, that's all I got to say about that. Gets the overtime winner, and that's wrong as far as I'm concerned.